Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about linear regression using R. In this video, I try to estimate production function with the specification you can see in the first row of this slide. It is from Greene's econometrics book. Source of the dataset is Gretl database. You can find more accurate references in the video description as well. First of all, we have to import our data into R. So, for getting the dataset, I use function named read.csv. As an argument, R needs first the location of the dataset. Secondly, I set the header option to true, because my table has a header. As it is from a CSV file, I also have to tell that it is separated by comma in this case. It is also important that I create a new variable or so-called object to store my data, and I call this new object just data. After all of this, I use structure function to discover how to import a table looks like in R. It has 41 observations and 3 variables. By now, almost everything is ready to calculate linear regression. Here, we want to estimate production function. Dependent variable is Q divided by A, and the only regressor is labor to capital ratio. Additionally, all variables are in logarithmic terms in order to ensure linearity. Therefore, I replace Q with Q divided by A, and then I calculate the natural logarithm of every variables. After that, I use the LM function for calculating regression. Here, the dependent variable is Q, and the independent is capital to labor ratio, denoted by small k. I separate them in the argument with a tilde sign. It is also possible to take a look at the results of this regression if I use summary function. Here, you can see a table that helps us to interpret these results. First, it is very useful to write down the estimated equation, as you can see here. Notice that the coefficient of the explanatory variable comes from the first column of the results table together with its sign. Coefficient of capital to labor ratio here means that 1% change in capital to labor ratio leads to a 0.25% increase in Q. This interpretation can be derived from logarithmic form of the equation. There are also a lot of useful information in that summary table. For example, we can see the results of the global F test that answers the question whether the model exists at all. Its null hypothesis is that our model doesn't exist. Here, pi value is smaller than 0.05, so we can reject the null hypothesis and have to say that our model exists. Partial t-tests report that the explanatory variable is needed in the model or not. You can see the result of t-test in the third and fourth column of the summary table. Null hypothesis is also that the variable is not needed to explain the dependent variable. We can see from that that both constant and labor to capital ratio has a pi value that is smaller than 0.05. So, they are needed in the model. Please note that in this case, global F-test and partial T-test are equal because we only have one dependent and one explanatory variable. One more thing is to check is R-squared that shows how strong the explanatory power of the model is. We can report a value that as large as 0.94 or approximately 94%. This is a really high R-squared and seems to be convincing, but note that in some cases too high R-squared may refer to false regression. At the end of this section, I have collected all the functions I have used during the work. You may check their documentation pages to gain more information about them. Thanks for watching. Bye.